these two fighters, how good was it in your view?
I mean, all three fights tonight were worth the price of admission. Superfly 2 lived up to the hype and exceeded the hype. The main event was tremendous, ebbs and flows, back and forth. One fighter was the power puncher who was looking for the big shot. The other fighter was the classic boxer. They dueled it out, they battled it out, and the 12th round will probably be, you know, nominated for round of the year at some point this year. So you hate to see somebody lose in a fight like that, but somebody has to lose. And Soren Vesai won, and he's moving on to bigger and better things.
Unofficially, it's the kind of fight about which you get to say, Max Kellerman, and I love saying it, there were really two winners.
Yeah, by the way, Nietes is a master fighter, and I hope we get to see more of him. I'm glad that we got to see him tonight. And a royal congratulations, he's reached a new level in his career, but the main event. Look, Soreng Vesai is a guy who went from a crowd-pleasing, aggressive puncher to a fighter who looks like he might be great. He might be headed for the Hall of Fame. He is the super flyweight champion of the world, and he did it by outboxing in stretches a master boxer himself in Estrada, who, by the way, looks to me like a 15-round fighter fighting in a 12-round era. As Andre said, he's a back-half fighter and maybe ran out of rounds to win tonight. By the way, I'm not convinced that he didn't win tonight. That was a close, tough fight, and there were some rounds we gave Soren Vesai because it felt like he was the puncher with momentum, that if you watch closely, Estrada seemed to land a lot of effective punches himself. That was a close, tough fight, and the scoring reflected that.
And like I said, no losers in a fight like that. They were both winners in a tremendous performance by both fighters. Well, our road through 2018 on HBO Boxing is underway.